If you walk on water, you can walk beside of me. If you heal the blind man, you can make me see. If you make the land to walk, if you calm the seas, I will follow you with all of me. Just singing, Jesus, Jesus, you saved my soul. You gave my heart new life. And now I know that when my life gets hard, I know just what to do.
Welcome to Kids Church. I'm so glad you could be here today. Today we're going to talk about another parable. Can anybody remember what a parable is? If you said that it's just another word for a story, you're right. A parable is just a fancy word for saying story. And Jesus uses these parables to teach people about important lessons. Before we get into today's parable, we're going to begin with a quick opening prayer. And we're going to begin our prayer with the sign of our cross. So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. God, thank you for sending your Son to be our good shepherd. He gave his life for us. Help us to follow him and trust him to protect us from the evil one. In Jesus' name, Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So in our parable for today, Jesus wants to teach the people that we are like sheep. He doesn't mean that we look like sheep, but rather that we act like sheep. Sheep are followers, and they depend on a shepherd to lead them to safety. That is true for us too. Now we're going to watch a video that teaches us about today's parable.
Hey kids, have you ever seen a sheep? They're pretty cute, but they are pretty weak. They can't defend themselves at all, and wolves like to attack them.
That's why there are shepherds. A shepherd's job is to lead a sheep's pasture and protect them.
So why are we talking about sheep? Well, that's because that's what today's parable is about. Let's jump in.
This parable starts out with Jesus telling the people that shepherds enter the pasture through the gate, but thieves climb over the fence. The sheep will recognize their shepherd's voice and follow them. They won't follow a thief's voice because they don't recognize him. Instead, they will run away.
The people listening didn't really understand why Jesus was telling them this.
So he told them in a little different kind of a way.
He said, "He is the gate for the sheep. Those who go through him will be saved and be able to run around in good pastures. Everyone who came before him was a thief and robber, but his true sheep didn't listen to them. Their purpose was to hurt the sheep, but his purpose was to help them."
Then he said he was also the shepherd. He would give up his life for the sheep. Others would just run away when danger came, because they didn't really care about the sheep. He also says that he has sheep that aren't in his flock yet, but they will be someday.
Now that's still pretty confusing. Jesus is talking about sheep, sheep, and more sheep.
So what does this all mean? People are like sheep who need a shepherd.
Jesus isn't talking about actual sheep in the story. He's just using them to talk about people.
And just like sheep, people need somebody to lead them and keep them safe.
We need a shepherd, and that shepherd is Jesus. Jesus is a good shepherd because he died for his sheep.
Just like in the parable, Jesus said he died for his sheep, and he did just that.
He died on the cross to keep us safe from our sin, and one day we get to be in heaven with him.
Everyone who follows Jesus gets to have real life. Jesus keeps us safe so we can run around in safe pastures. Memory verse.
The thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. There will be people in your life that just want to make you feel sad.
But Jesus isn't one of those people. He wants you to have a good life.
And just like sheep follow a shepherd, we should follow Jesus.
So kids, next time you see a sheep, think of this parable.
Think about how they follow their shepherd and how you should follow Jesus.
What a great video. So we will have people in our lives that want to lead us down the wrong path. And this path often leads us to danger. But Jesus came to lead us towards safety. He came to die for our sins and save us, and he wants to lead us towards a life he has planned for us. So we have a job, and we need to listen to Jesus and not those friends who are looking for trouble. Thanks for joining us today on Kids Church, and don't be afraid to pull out your Bible and read this parable with your family. You'll be able to find it in John chapter 10, verses 10 to 18. That's all for today, and we'll see you next week.
Hey guys, thanks for hanging out with us today. If you're new, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn on post notifications so you never miss what we're up to. Also, follow us on social media and check out our website, gslakeshore.com/kids, for fun activities. Bye!